it's even too big. That's what she said. Me. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45. Yeah, I needed to think. From the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is about cream products. I am exactly the same as in last week's video. Because yeah, it's still the same. It's still the same day. The only difference is now I have brows on my face. So I don't have a naked behind face, as I always like to say. So what I'm going to show you today is how I, where I place my cream products and how I apply them. So usually what I start with, oh, let me first kind of tell you that the Makeup 101 series that this is a part of, I did not say that, did I? It has its own playlist. It will be listed down below. And there is a reason when the why the videos are in the order that they are. The episodes are kind of built upon each other. So, you know, if you want to know, for instance, how I prep my face, how I apply my foundation, it is all in those separate videos. And what is my qualification? Well, besides the fact that I am 45 and doing my own makeup, that's basically it. I'm not a makeup artist. I cannot do, well, I can do makeup on others, but yeah, I'm not good at it at all, not gonna lie. And I am not saying that I am very, very good at applying my own makeup, because I'm still learning as well. It's just that I have found that when I got older, yeah, stuff happened. And truly, in the few years that I have been on YouTube, I have already needed to relearn some application techniques, and I thought maybe it is maybe it's beneficial for you too to share what I have learned. So yeah, I know that there are a lot of videos out there on how to apply cream products and what the function is and all that. So I think that we all kind of know that basically there are two ways to go about this. One is what you find pleasing to your own eye on your own face, and the other one is to enhance or change your facial features. You can do both at the same time. You can do either one, whatever floats your boat. You could just do cream products, you could not do cream products, it does not really matter. I have found though that I kind of like to use cream products, and that sometimes, especially with some foundations, that I kind of like to just use cream products and then set my face lightly on top of that, and then I'm good to go. Other times I'm like, no, I want to go full glam. I want to be here for 3 hours and yeah, be very, very extra and not apply just cream products, but powder products as well. Sometimes I just go for the powder products. I don't know. I do feel though that anyway, I had to stop filming for a little bit and now I kind of forgot what I was saying. So that's handy, isn't it? I think I was talking about the fact that you can really sculpt your face or just do what you find aesthetically pleasing. For instance, blush draping. I love blush draping. It kind of has a little bit of both, you know. It sculpts your face, but it also adds a little bit of, I don't know, artisticness maybe. And if you don't like that look, then you don't like that look. If you love the look, then you love the look. There is obviously a theory behind it, and you can play with light and dark. You know, something that is dark or a shadow pushes back, and something that you brighten or highlight is coming forward. That is what you try to do if you would try to basically cover this or correct this. In the hollows that you can see happening here, you put something that is bright to push it forward. So to optically even out that layer, which I'm very, very bad at. So that is why you can still see it. But yeah, what can you do about it? Usually, especially with heavy eye makeup on, this is not noticeable anyway, because people are going immediately up. So yeah, at least the contour stick that I used to use is not the correct shade for me at all. So I don't know if what I will use today is the correct shade, but I will show you at least the placement or how I do it. It doesn't necessarily mean that it is the best way though. It is just the way that I do it, and I keep on watching videos on how to sculpt your face, and I get the theory behind it, but sometimes doing it on yourself can be a little bit of a thing now, doesn't it? So my foundation has already set. It isn't powdered except underneath my eyes. Usually I start with contour. So the contour that I am going to use today, I'm just going to use this. I don't know, it's probably too warm, but yeah, it kind of is what I have, I think. Let's see what else I have. Basically, what you want to look out for is the cool versus warm thing, because shadows are cool or grayer toned, and bronzer is either more yellow golden or maybe even a little bit more red, depending on your natural undertone. If I go and outside and my face gets darker, it doesn't go red, yeah, unless I am too long in the sun. But you know, the color that I have is not a red based one. So I have found out that if I use a red based bronzer, that it kind of looks weird on me. Also, because we are more in the lines of winter, I don't want a very heavy bronzed look either, because I personally don't like that. I have seen others though, and that's gorgeous if they are basically overly bronzed, but for me it is not that. Also, I have to say, I don't know if I did that in the previous episodes, I don't think so. I do outside makeup, so my makeup, I want to look nice on camera, but also outside, because I am filming for a very small part of the day and I don't immediately take off my makeup, usually at least. If I am just going to put on makeup to film, yeah, then I don't care as much how it looks outside, because then it is more along the lines of how it looks on camera. Basically, it is the more full coverage and matte a foundation is, the better it looks on camera. But I don't like the way that it looks on me, at least outside. So yeah, but that's not what we're doing here, right? So I have a few options, but I actually think that all of them are too warm to contour with. Maybe this is a better one. This was actually my bronzer stick from Kiko. Maybe I can contour with this, because I think this is the coolest one that I have right now. So let's do that. So how do I usually contour? I don't paint on the face, because I don't like that. I want a sculpt that is soft. I don't want it very, very harsh. I want it soft. Again, I'm doing it for outside as well. So what I actually do is I have the bronzer stick here, or a concealer, or whatever you use. If I use a concealer, a darker concealer, I put it on my hand and then I tap over it, because that is how I like to work with it. The brush that I have is this one. This is from BH Cosmetics, from their Rose Gold Setter number 4. But this is just the brush that I like to work with, because it is a little bit... maybe it's even too big. But yeah, it's the brush I like. What you could also do is something like this, which is more of a concealer buffer brush, especially for nose or even for here. But I don't know. I actually use this one a lot of the time. And what do? I paint. So I paint it on the brush a bit. And then if I'm using something new, I tap on my hand. This one is a little bit more creamy than the Fenty stick that I had, so I kind of need to see how. And then when you look at my face, you can kind of see that natural shadow forming, right? That is what I want to do. But what I can do, because my face is a little bit older, I can kind of start there. But what I usually do is I push it up a tiny bit as well to make it a little bit more sculpted. So I just turn my head, and this is where that shadow is. And basically I push it up a bit. So I flick it up. I don't really go like that or buff. I usually flick it up. And that is one of the reasons why I like to paint it on the brush instead of on my face. Because I don't know, I feel like I almost have more control. And again, I just push it up. And I try to follow my line a little bit without going too far in. Because if I end up here, it is giving me a wrong... And then I can kind of lightly go over it, basically like I do with my eyeshadow. Sometimes I do like to bring it forward a tiny bit just to fade it out a little. And that is how I sculpt there. And I even actually, now looking in the viewfinder, find that it goes too straight down like this. So I actually prefer it a little bit higher up. So I'm just going to kind of buff it out a little bit more, so that it looks like that. I don't know if it does a lot, but I do kind of like the way that it looks. So again, I'm painting on the brush, finding my natural shadow, and that is where I place the brush. So in the natural shadow, almost in the center of that natural shadow, I place the brush, and then I place it lightly, and then I go up a little. Now, please don't ask me how to contour a round face, because I don't know. I truly, truly don't know. I don't have one. And as I have said before, I'm not a makeup artist either. So, but this is how I do it. So I find the natural shadows in my face and I kind of enhance them a little bit. If you are around, maybe I can... Now, I'm trying to round out my cheeks, but it doesn't happen. We all have cheekbones, right? Even if you have a very round face, we all have cheekbones. So what I want to do then, even when I was a little bit rounder in the face, 10 kilos up, basically last year, I still kind of contoured here. But what I did then, I actually did this to find where it was and to feel where my cheekbone was, because that is what I wanted to accentuate. But basically, you look at your face shape. So if you have a very pronounced cheekbones, maybe you don't want to accentuate them this way. Maybe you actually want to contour basically here a little bit to make your face a little bit rounder. It is all playing. Just if you don't really know how to contour your face, what you can do is just go sit in front of the mirror. The best part is if you have a three-way like this or multiple mirrors like I have, just play around with it. Even maybe make a picture to see what you like, what you find most flattering for you. And I kind of hope that makes sense. So yeah, again, a lot of the time I kind of, because something happens here in my face, it is the muscle that goes here, I like to hug here a little bit, just a tiny bit, but again, not too far in, because then it does this, and that is not what I want. So yeah, what else I like to do is not specifically nose contour. A lot of the time I don't even contour my nose. I can though, sometimes I just do it with this brush, just make sure I don't have enough, and just go over the sides like this, and maybe like that. That is what I do. Now I know that there are a lot of people who really contour their nose. I usually do not, because I don't know, I find it too much of an effort. What I can do though is contour a little bit more. So I have a smaller brush. Again, I paint the brush and then stipple it to get excess product off. And I can also contour here. Oh no, I forgot my Nabla lip plumper. You can also do this. But basically what I'm doing is I'm actually darkening up the natural shadow that is there to push the rest forward a little bit. Like that. You can do that here too if you want to. I know that some people also do that here a little bit. I usually do not, because I am too lazy. What I also really like to do is do the jawline. So again, I paint my brush and then I kind of see how much I have. Okay, not a lot. So what I do is I tilt my, again, find that natural shadow and just go just below the jaw. So I hope I can show you. So basically here, that is how I place my brush. Now here, because I'm older, you get that part going, you know? So there I kind of just tap a little bit and try to make that line a little bit more straight. You don't want a harsh line here. And again, you just want something softer. And something that actually helped me a lot was a contouring video by Alexandra. I really don't know how to pronounce her last name. I think it's Anil, I hope. I will link her channel down below. She's also, she's fair to light olive, but she has a contour video in where she shows how she does her jawline. I know that she has a different method right now, but that video taught me a lot. So basically I am again looking at, what's there? Of course. Finding that shadow and basically making sure that that line is a little bit neater. And then hopefully making sure I don't have black spots underneath my chin. And then for underneath the jaw, what I usually do is I just look forward and then basically, again, find that natural shadow and just fill it in a little bit, just lightly. And this is the reason why you don't, I have a red spot there, why you don't want something that is very warm. Because if I were to put, for instance, this one is pretty cool for me, so it might be actually perfect now that I have my correct foundation shade. But this one, for instance, is too warm to use as a contour. If I use it as a contour, it looks like I've been hit in the face. It's just not very pretty. I can, however, use this as a bronzer. I can also use this one as a bronzer. So let's use this one again because it has been a while. So that is what I do after. I go now to my bronzer and I have a brush like this. Again, paint the face or paint the brush. I know that this is a more pigmented formula, so I'm basically tapping on my hand. And what I do is I start at my forehead, but I start high. And I paint back, basically. Paint a little bit more into my hairline. Because for me, it's very easy to clean up. And again, building up is easier than taking away. So I'm just following my forehead a little bit. And then I go a little bit more in. And then now I'm pulling it down. Stippling and pulling it down. Maybe pushing it a little bit forward. If I need more product, I can get it off of my hand first. So what you want to do is bring back a little bit more warmth. Now, because of the hairstyle that I have a pretty big forehead, right? Or at least that's how it looks. So I want it a little bit smaller. I don't want it very tiny, but I want it a little bit smaller. And if I am out in the sun, this is where the sun would naturally hit. Preferably softly, so I don't, you know. Also, I like it if it is a little bit more here as well. Then what I do is I actually skip, a lot of the times I skip this part. So I skip here and then I go underneath a little bit more and tap it lightly there. To give a little bit of warmth to the face and then I go up. So I do hit this area, but very, very lightly. So it is again just to bring back a little bit of warmth to the face. Now you can, if you want to sculpt with a bronzer, you can. You know, no one's saying that you shouldn't, but... So I kind of do sculpt a little bit with my bronzer too, but differently. And I just look at what I like in my face. So now basically you get that again. And I like it. So what I also want to do is a little bit on my nose as well. Just the size of the nose there. And then lightly again, basically connecting it a little bit. So that it has been like I have been in the sun. So I want to sculpt, but I also want to bring back a little bit of the warmth in a little bit more of a natural way. That is what I'm going for right now. And I think actually that I have achieved that quite nicely. To be honest with you, I am feeling a little bit more, I'm feeling a little bit too bronzed on my forehead. So what I do then is I just grab my sponge and go over it. That's what I mean by I don't really like an overly bronzed face. I just feel like it looks weird on me. So yeah, I go over it with my sponge just to make sure that everything is blended the way that I want it. Okay, what I can do then is just clean up my face a little bit. The cloth is dirty though, because it needs to go to the wash. And again, I pull backwards instead of forwards. So that I remove the product, but also kind of, I don't know, blend it back into my hair a little bit. So there's that part. Yes, that is... Oh, I really like how this is looking. Never mind. Sometimes that happens. So for cream blush, I have a few different options. I have... again, I like something that is... I don't know, I like skin tints. So for instance, the MUA has a skin tint. I like that. I also have the Sweet Cheeks from NYX that I like the formula of as well. They are a little bit more, it's a little bit of a drier formula. I also have ColourPop, Super Shock, and I have this one, the Cheek Slime from Frack and Fielding. I love this formula. I wish that there are two colors, but that other color is a bit too light for me, and I think too cool toned as well. This for me is the perfect, basically neutral, orangey blush. It's basically the shade of the cap for me, which works very, very well with my skin tone. If you are warmer of skin tone, this works very well. I do have different ways of applying everything though. So if I have, for instance, this one, the Super Shock Cheek, especially this color, because it's very dark for me and pretty pigmented, I tried using the butt of a sponge, but it gets patchy on me. So for something like this, or for a thicker formula. So basically for a thicker formula, I use a brush like this, which is dense. I've mentioned this in the brush video as well. It's a dense brush from EcoTools. I think it's their, what is it? Precision blush brush from EcoTools. If I have a very thin formula, like a skin tint, for instance, I use something that is, this is actually a highlighter brush from LOV, but this is more fluffy and more open, so not as dense. And that's the difference. So I want something that is a little bit more flat topped and open for my skin tint, so that it has a little bit more air. And if I have a formula that is denser, I want a denser brush. I don't exactly know why, but I have found that I like that. I also have a cream highlighter, or at least a Super Shock highlighter. I usually apply that with my fingers. And a lot of the time, not gonna lie, I forget to put on a cream highlighter. If I use a cream highlighter, I use it now. So basically, I use it underneath my blush. Let's use it with a brush, because I can. That's the reason. I don't feel like using my finger today. That's what she said. And basically, I place it from the top down. Do you see where I'm placing it? So basically on the high point where the light hits, but not just. So the most product goes on the top and then I blend it down a bit. Why? Because I find that very, very pleasing. If I just do it here, It gives me a stripe, you know. So when I basically blend it down a little bit and back, just on my cheekbone, I'm even going too far in now. I don't know. It just does something extra. And I can also, if I want to, do a little bit on the nose, a little bit. Yeah, I usually don't do the chin though. Usually I just keep to here and then maybe a little bit underneath my brow. And I really fade it down, and I like it if I have a shimmer. Basically, this whole area is a little bit shiny. I like that. This is in the color Wisp, and for me, it is a very, very pretty color. I don't know. Let's use this one. It does not really matter. Usually, I look at the colors that I have, and I look at what I want to do on my eyes, and then I kind of try to match it a little bit. The nice thing about this one is because it is more of a, it's almost more of a neutrally tone. You're not really, but it looks pretty good on my skin, so I'm going to use this. How do I use this? I actually put it on my hand, like so. And then I take the brush. And first I work the product a bit, just to make sure that I don't have a lot. Then I start there. There. So, yeah, I like it that way. So some people like to start here in the apple of their eye or way out back. I kind of start right underneath my eye. And then I tap the product on and I go up, because I like a little bit of blush draping. I like that. And I'm kind of experimenting with a little bit of the placement as well. Sometimes I bring my blush a little bit more forward, other times I don't. It kind of depends on how I'm feeling. What you don't want to do when you're older is do this. Then do your blush. Because if you do this, you don't walk around like this all day, right? So if you do this, then it drags everything down. So for an older skin, if you want a bit more of a lifted effect, it's actually better, or usually more flattering, to go back and then up into the hairline. Or, I don't know, blush draping, like I do, because I like it. And this kind of sculpts the face as well. Now you can build stuff up. The more I pull it forward, the more, I don't know, I feel like I have been out in the sun too long with sunglasses on. And that is not a look that I like, on me at least. But on others, I think that looks very, very cute, you know, if their blush placement is more forward. But for me, I don't know, I don't feel like, sometimes I kind of want to add it a little bit more forward, but a lot of the time I actually don't. But if I bring it forward, I'm looking forward into the camera or into the mirror with my face relaxed, and I place it where you see it right now. Instead of doing this, I place it there to give a little bit of a fuller effect. But I don't go around smiling all day. Basically, this is my resting bitch face. So I want everything to look good as is then, you know. I personally also like a blush on the nose. And sometimes I like to blush the tip of the nose. Sometimes I go a little bit higher. But again, what I want to avoid is that this is too red, that I get that mask effect, you know? What I do like though is if I have a clean brush, basically go in between a little bit, just to make sure that the flow is good. But not too much, because now I feel like I have too much on the nose, so I take the sponge again and just go over, and I basically pounce it in a little bit. Not specifically here, but again on the front. And that is basically how I use cream products to sculpt the face. That's how I do it. Is this the best way? No. It's just the way that I like to do it right now. And I kind of hope that it was helpful a little bit. So basically what you want to achieve, or at least what I want to achieve with the sculpting products that I use right now, is, I don't know, I want to give a little bit more structure to my face without having everything hang too much. But I also don't want to have cheeks that go like this, because I personally don't like it on me. So I do try to keep this area a little bit lighter, but I still kind of want product there as well, you know? Does that make any sense at all? I don't know. I hope so. So yeah, that when I look in the mirror, I'm like, yeah, I like the way that this that's looking. That is how I want to sculpt. And I know that theoretically the best way to sculpt is to do it like this, because instead of this. So don't do it like this, because that basically brings your face down a little bit more. Go like this and start further back and then go up, because you want everything lifted. That is the theory behind it. And one day, some days I stick to it and other days I do not. The only thing left for me to do right now is freckles. Why? Because I really love the way that freckles look. I actually think that for me, I don't want to say they make me look younger, but they make it look more natural. And why do I say that? Because I actually have, I don't necessarily have freckles, but what I do have is hyperpigmentation, especially in summer. So I kind of turn stuff into freckles then. Also, if you have a pimple, turn it into a freckle. It's a very long-winded way of saying I like to give myself four freckles. I use my Lottie London one. It's almost empty, but I have a backup, so that's good. And this placement changes every time as well. But basically, this is what I do. Then I grab a sponge or my finger. It depends. And I just do that. I don't know. I just think that it adds something fun. And yeah, maybe even younger. I don't know. I feel kind of naked now without my freckles. So yeah, I don't know. I feel like it kind of ties everything in together a little bit. It gives me a little bit of color here without giving me a lot of color there. Yeah? And you can go as far as you want to with this, because there are no rules. It is like Robert Welsh always says, there are no rules to makeup, but there is a theory. And I agree with that. You know, it kind of, I usually don't really like to talk about the word rules, but maybe structure. I don't know. There's the framework that you work within. Maybe that is better. I don't know, people. So yeah, this is it for cream products. How I apply them. Again, for me, it is all about light layers, and formulas that I personally like are skin tints. So for instance, as I said, the MUA is a skin tint. I don't know if it's available in the USA though. I know it's available here in Europe. Beauty Bay sells them. If they are not out of stock, Beauty Bay has them. I know that there are a lot more brands, even drugstore brands, who have skin tints like this, but they are, at least what I have seen and that I can get here, they are not from cruelty-free brands. So this is the brand that I have. I really like these. And if you use them on your hand first and then tap and make sure that your brush is not too wet, it is very easy to use it on your face and it won't disrupt your foundation too much. And then this one, the Fielding, yeah, the cheek slime, I really like this consistency a lot. So if you have one of these and you have a similar consistency in your cream products, let me know, because I'm curious. I also really like these, which are a little bit more, these have a doe foot and they are a little bit more dry. to apply, but still very, very pretty. It is a mousse texture. And then, of course, we have the Super Shock shadows from ColourPop that I also like. I have noticed, though, that blush sticks are not really my favorite. That is it for today's video. Yes, I hope it was helpful. I hope it made sense. And then that's going to be it. Let me know down below some of your favorite products to cream sculpt with. And maybe you have some tips and tricks for me as well. Yes, I'm going to go to the site and give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to the merch shop in case you want to browse there. Yes. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.